Today, let's review the PowerApps Studio screen for mobile app making together. Hi, this is Magnigami, Lean Sigma Black Belt. Today, we are doing the second video of our PowerApps app making project. The amazing part of this software is that it makes a sample app from source data automatically. In the last video, I talked about tips for preparing source data and procedures up to generating the sample app. Please click the link above and watch that video. From today, I'll actually show you PowerApps screen. This is a sample app made from my source data. It's much quicker than making an app from scratch. This operating environment is called PowerApps Studio. Let's check each section of the screen and its tips. See the left lane of the screen. Here are the names of all parts actually in your app. This square icon represents a screen. By clicking the left triangle, you can show or hide the all parts such as labels and icons on the screen. Click the line of dots. Then from the next menu, you can move the screen up and down or delete the screen. By selecting another screen icon, you can easily move to that screen. Next, let's look at the parts inside the screen. By clicking a name, you can directly select that part and edit it. By controlling these parts, you can design each screen and add necessary functions. Later, you'll refer to these parts from various places. If you keep those default names, it may not be easy to identify which parts they are referred to, and this may cause errors because of misreferring. Therefore, it's better to rename each icon to brief name you can easily understand. You can do that easily by double-clicking on them. Since we cannot use the exact same names, for example, if it's in screen 1, I put 1 at the end of all names on the screen. Gallery is among the types of parts. You can show a list of specific data with it very easily. Next, look at the right side of the screen. It shows the properties of the part currently selected. Here, you can change many settings for each part. The types of properties change according to the type of the selected part. Like Excel, there is a formula bar in PowerApps too. By selecting a property from the drop list on the left, you can also change the settings. By setting properties and formulating PowerApps functions, you can create mobile apps without writing difficult code. In the future, I'll make more videos about PowerApps functions too. Let's take a look at the menu bar above. In Home, there are commands that you use frequently, and you use them to change the shape, color, and size of the selected part. This usage is the same as in Excel and PowerPoint, which you may already be familiar with. You can add new parts with Insert. Click the controls. Look at these controls. In addition to the usual button and drop-down, this software has a date picker, so users can pick dates from the calendar, and slider, so users can input numerical values by slide. You can easily add these functions to your app. I'll explain the other menus, view and action, another time. Move to the right, and there are several buttons. The first button is App Checker. Clicking the button opens a new section. If there are errors in your app, this section will show you the error explanation and offer solution hints. The next buttons are Command, Undo, and Redo. With the next triangle button, you can review your app anytime. It's not necessary to memorize all of today's content. You should just grasp the overall picture of the operation. After all, it's important to begin using them. Thank you very much for viewing. Please click the subscribe button. Also, click and watch my other related videos. Thanks.